media and design. I wanted to put together a series of webisodes and podcasts on recording techniques. I basically call these guerrilla recording techniques. These are focusing more on newer artists, younger bands, just people who are constrained to a budget, basically, for the recording, and that can really be a bitch sometimes. About using mid-grade gear to establish the biggest sound you possibly can, and just some little techniques that I've learned along the way that actually help out with this. My background, I've been in the music industry for about 20 years, I guess. I'm professionally in the studio for about 14. I'm a drummer by trade, by nature, I guess you would say. Played drums for about 30 years, actually, and also a vocalist. I'm going to focus this episode on capturing a great room sound for your drums, just with one microphone, with an overall sound of the room. I know what it's like to be a drummer and go into a studio and spend hours upon hours trying to accomplish a good drum sound with an engineer or producer that's not really focused on the drums. So, just kind of wanted to help you out. I'm going to be putting together, like I said, a series of these quick webisodes and podcasts on just basic little recording techniques to help you out. So, hope you enjoy it. So, I was working with a band recently called Unloaded.ca. They're a 7-piece classic rock band. Really, really good musicians. I can't stress enough on how that helps in a recording to have really great musicianship. It's half the battle right there. It was a very difficult session because they wanted to record everything live off the floor. And that can be a real bitch sometimes, especially when they have two vocalists, a male and a female, playing acoustic guitar, and they want to actually hear it through a PA coming through the room itself. Plus, they also had a horn section with a saxophone player. That can cause a lot of problems. They threw the screw into me right at the very last minute because you're going to hear a lot of blowback, a lot of bleed into the microphones. So I thought the best way to do it, just try it and see how it works out. So basically what I did was, the drummer was really good. Of course, multi-mic'd all the drums, the kick, the snare, the toms, the cymbals, the hi-hat. But I wanted to achieve a really good room sound just to try to get that John Bonamy when the levee breaks kind of sound, which is almost impossible anyways, but I thought we'd give it a shot. I don't work for Blue, this isn't a commercial for their microphones. In some sense it is, because I've just blown away with the quality of a Blue microphone. I have a few of them actually, but the one that we're concentrating on for this session was the Blue Spark. This Blue Spark here, I basically just used as the setting that it has. It's got the two in and outs on it for a wide panel and for a close panel. Basically, it's $199. And I used an alternate mic stand, one of the ones that could stretch up to like 13 feet. The room itself is about a 10-foot ceiling. So basically took the microphone, angled it at about 70, 75 degrees down, at about 8 feet up from the drummer, and about 4 feet right directly in front of the kit. And it was simply actually blown away with the isolation this microphone had to capture the room sound. I just couldn't stress enough on how amazing this thing was. So how I basically work with this is I'm using Logic Pro. I also have like an M-Audio Fast Track Pro. We were using a Presonus Eureka channel strip. And just kind of basically put the compression on it, not any effects really or anything like that, and used some compression that was in the DAW itself. Just a tiny bit of compression just to bring it in a little bit closer. I didn't want to use any reverb on it actually. I wanted to see if the room itself could just establish that wide pattern, and it really did. Unloaded.ca is a really dynamic band. They have a lot of classic rock, they have a lot of slower rock, a little bit of Pink Floyd, a little bit of Zeppelin, AC/DC, things like that. So there is a dynamic there with heavier sounds and lighter sounds. And so I was really trying to let the room do the work for it. It worked out really well, and it's the music that you're actually hearing in the background, and I'll also put a little excerpt of the actual drums in a hole and the isolation of just the room microphone itself.
Okay, this is the full mix. Drums in stereo. I should mention as well that you can use any condenser for this, just not the Blue Spark. Now this is the mix just with the Blue Spark, just the room sound only.
How the pattern worked is I just basically plugged the microphone in, like I said, and just ran that as a separate channel. In the mix, I basically just ran a spreader on it. So you can use your actual plug-in spreader from Logic or whatever DAW you're using, but I was using a Wave Audio Center channel spreader. Just brought it out a bit. I didn't actually use any reverb at all with it. The room itself was amazing. It just captured awesome. So in that sense, you can accomplish something really good with just one microphone. And how I really kind of modeled the mix around it was, I kind of isolated that one room sound microphone. Got a really good sound with the lows, the mids, the highs. Established off the pattern from the Blue. And then basically worked all the other drums around it. I left it as a center pan with the blue, and basically did individual pans for the kick, the snare, the hi-hats, just to give that larger separation spread, and of course put in the effects on each individual drum. But it was a really good reference pattern to actually hear everything coming through the room sound microphone, and the isolation, I said, was fabulous. None of the bleed from the saxophone really came through. The acoustic guitars and everything was minimum, but it gave that really natural reverb pattern that I was looking for. Not much delay, and it was not hard to work with at all. So I just wanted to let you know about that, and it was a really good technique, and I'll be doing more short series on, very quick series on recording techniques, and I think we're going to work with bass next, which is pretty simple, to accomplish a really amazing bass sound. So like I said, check back, and hope this helps you out a lot. My name is Dean, I'm from Echo Heart Media, and hope to see you next time. Thanks.